make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
we will rock you.
Blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing. As you can see, the English partition of the Millwall side are just walking on the field. They look very professional. There's quite a lot of them, actually. Looks like two teams, really. Should be a great game. Lots of heart, lots of fire, and lots of commitment. It's going to be a cracking game. As you can see, the rest of the world guys are taking this very seriously. You can see them warming up here. We have a couple of Welsh, Scottish, definite Australian standing over there. Argentinian fella. In the back is a Kiwi. The boys are definitely taking this seriously. You can see how they're warming up. I mean, look at Adam, for example. He is definitely taking this seriously. This is going to be a great game. It's a great day for it. It's about 28 degrees Celsius. And everyone is here, just waiting for the big moment. I'm standing here on the Millwall pitch, and as you can see, it's very hard. Today's going to be a tough game. It's going to be some bruises, some scrapes, maybe even some stitches. But man, that ball is going to bounce. We're in for a cracker, folks. Okay, here we are, folks. Kickoff is imminent. It's just a toss of the coin to see who kicks off and who receives. The referee is from a neutral country, I hope. Somewhere like Bangladesh or something. Although he doesn't look very Bangladeshi. We have the captains, Brian and Tiff, tossing the coin. And who has won the toss? Well, the England have won the toss. They will be receiving the kick from the rest of the world team. Shake the hands. Here we go, folks. There you have it from the ref. Oh, it's an unfortunate kickoff. It went directly out. It'll be a scrum in the halfway to the English. The English are lining up on the blind side with a split 2-2, with the fullback standing back and Tiff coming out calling out the calls. There you go, the defence comes up. Unfortunately, the English went down too quickly and it's a free kick to the rest of the world. There they take it up with Argentinian Pablo, takes it into the loose ruck. The ball is fed back and it's kept going forward. Oh, unfortunately, it's lost forward. English now have the ball. Oh, he's scragged. He is scragged badly. Oh, they're taking up big, strong man there. Toby's with the ball at the moment. He lies it back really well. That's a good pickup. The layback is there. Tiff's got the ball. Unfortunate slice on the ball. It's an unfortunate advantage there. The ref was playing for offsides against the rest of the world. English now have a kick on halfway. Tiff sizes up the post. The size is not a good kick. Goes for touch. And it's a good touch finder. Almost on the 22. The line-up call is made. Ball goes in. Oh, it's a long ball. Unfortunate knock on there. The ref calls it a skew throw. It's a scrum to the rest of the world. A big let off there. Big let off. Hopefully the fiery Matt Shorrock will get the ball in correctly. And the guys will shove them on and get it back. The ball's in. It's a good scrum. It's a good scrum. Unfortunately, they're getting shoved, but they get the ball back. Matt Sharp does very well. Oh, yes. And it's Cheese. Oh, he takes a big tackle there, unfortunately. He's driven back, but they win the ball. They win the ball. Yes, they do. It's come forward again. It's a ruck. Yes, it comes forward with Brian, and Brian is fighting it. And Big Adam Crawford is there to give momentum. Oh, he's straight in there. Oh, big tackle. Big tackle. Lays the ball back. Unfortunately, the ball is lost forward. And it's England ball. Toby takes it forward quite a few metres. It's Millwall driving it now. Well, the English Millwall. It's a thrown forward pass there. Advantage to the rest of the world. All the rest of the world needs a clean scrum. Feed it out and get it out. That's all they need. Ball's in. Oh, it's a big shove by the English. Oh, they have won a tight head. Oh, they lay it back. Oh, it's been held up. It's been held up by the rest of the world. Oh, and it's won by the rest of the world. Somehow they've managed to keep the ball. And it's a scrum again to the rest of the world. Rest of the world scrum. Let's see if they can make good use of the scrum. They're in an ideal position to take it up to the English line. They need a good shove. It's a good feed by Matt Sharrock. Oh, it's a much better scrum. It is being wheeled though. The ball is out and it's been held great in the back. Oh, well, Matty Sharrock has the ball. Oh, he's making a great little drive and Adam is there in support. Ball is laid back. Brian gets it, picks it up, and he goes. He needs support now. Yes, Matty Sharrock has the ball. Oh, it's out. Oh, that's a great little step there. Ball's going down. It's a ruck. It's a ruck. The ball is down. Yep. Matty Sharrock feeds the ball to fly half. Oh, he decides to go the other way. He's gone blind. Oh, he's held up. Oh, they lose the ball. Unfortunate forward pass there. The ref called. Ball's in. Westworld have the ball. Oh, unfortunately broke the tackle there. Swings it wide. Oh, it's a great take. That is a great take. Oh, it's a great offload to Tiff again. Tiff is making great inroads. He's almost on the 5 meter line. It's an England ruck. Oh, he goes on the blind. It seems he has scored in the corner. No, he has stepped out. The touch judge has called it out. Controversial decision. Let's just see what happens, folks. Oh yes, Brian takes the ball brilliantly and they drive it up. It's a good drive by the rest of the world team. They need quick ball though. Quick ball. Oh yeah, that is a great kick. That is a fantastic kick. Driving the English all the way back down, almost to their 22. Flex plays very brilliantly there. Oh, good step by Flex. He's taken down and it's a knock on. It will be the rest of the world scrum. That is great, great, great out of jail there. Ref must have called that properly. Ball goes to Toby. Toby takes it up. Oh, he's tackled quite brilliantly. Lays the ball back. Oh, he's let the ball go. Oh, and it's the bollocking Scottish props takes it up. The ball is laid back brilliantly. Brian feeds it. It's offside players all over the place. The ball is fed brilliantly. Oh, yes, it's taken brilliantly by Patrick, the American. He lays it back quite well. Matt picks it up, feeds it. He needs to feed this ball quite quickly. Oh, Jamie takes the ball. He keeps it inside. That's brilliant play. Brilliant pull by Jamie. Needs to get in there. They need to secure this ball. They're playing advantage. The ref is playing advantage. Not quite what for, though. Yes, it's offsides. From the side. There you go. You can hear Brian speaking to his players. He's actually the captain. Made a fault early on. Matt Shorrock is the vice captain. Here comes Pablo with the ball. He found it in the pond behind us. They need a good feed. Oh, unfortunately it's stolen by the English. Toby breaks away, but he's running sideways, going nowhere. That's a great tackle there. Carl has the ball now. Lays it back brilliantly. Oh, it's a quick ball. Great ball there. English still seem to have the control of the ball. Yes, they have. Feeds it out to Tiff. Oh, it's a great inside ball there. To the flanker, the young flanker. He's only 15 years old. Oh, it's a great inside ball again. They seem to be using that quite often now. But it is working for them. He's rucked over. Oh, the ball is out. Unfortunately, the rest of the world almost had the ball there. It's a great tackle by Brian. He needs support. That's a great tackle by the stupendous, immense Adam Crawford. Certainly stopped a try there. Ball is fed back. Unfortunately, the English have an advantage for offsides, I believe it is. Adam Crawford's just getting his feet now after that great tackle. No, they haven't used the advantage, and the ref is going to bring them back for the penalty. I believe it was offsides against the rest of the world. Couldn't really see it from my position though, but is the ref's call. Well, the English running up quite drastically, and they've scored right under the poles. There's a great score by the English, and he's going to kick for poles. Here he goes. Here he goes, little under nine kicker. He lines it up. Oh, and he kicks it straight through the post. Great kick. Great kick by one of the little under nine players. Man, he has the ball in the hand. He feeds it now. It's a much better scrum. Oh, the ball is out. It's hacked forward by Carl. Cheese picks the ball up. Oh, he's been held up brilliantly by Carl and loses the ball. That's a great pickup by the English. Oh, they're driving forward now. Hopefully they can bring him down. It's in the 22 now. The ball is stolen by the rest of the world. That's a brilliant play. Hopefully they can keep it though. Knock forward by the knock forward by the English. It's the rest of the world scrum again. Here we go. It's another scrum to the rest of the world in their 22. A big pressure situation. Hopefully they win the scrum back. Oh, they're getting shoved off the ball again. Oh, it's picked up at the back brilliantly. Oh, it's a great little offload. Unfortunately, the kick has not gone out. Flex has retrieved it. Craig has lined him up. Oh, he has tackled him without the ball. All right, you tackled him on the pass. There's no problem, says the ref. That will put some fear into God, into Flex. Ball is laid back quite brilliantly. Oh, Tiff takes the ball. Great step. Knocks it on. And Craig Kruger's on him like a honey on toast. Craig Kruger has come on the field with some serious anger problems. Hopefully he gets the ball and runs it straight through them. He is looking very upset. The ball needs to come out quickly. Oh yes it does, and it comes out quite well. And it's fed back. Oh, the ball is offloaded and it's fed straight to an English player. They get it going forward. Oh, it's a clear try. Great score by the English. Very big mistake made there by the rest of the world. And the English have run out clear leaders. With a conversion to come, it'll be 14-0. He kicks off. Oh, it's a poor kickoff. He leaves the ball. Oh, the ref has called it. That is the third time the rest of the world have done that. They have just given away advantage. They need to get it over their 10-yard line. And the English have a scrum again, and the way the rest of the world scrum is going at the moment, it is going to be a telling factor. It's a much better scrum by the rest of the world. Oh, the scrummy is scragged. Oh, Flush cleans up brilliantly, holds the ball up. Oh, yes, he needs support though. Oh, he's turned over, unfortunately. It's an English ball. Tiff feeds the ball out wide. Oh, he's taken out by Craig Kruger very brilliantly. Oh, I put him in touch. Oh, he has put out touch. Craig Kruger has just hurt someone quite badly. And it was a great tackle straight in the ribs.
Come on, Will!
That was a telling tackle by Craig Kruger. I think it's going to make a huge influence on the game. I think when he gets the ball, he's going to make a huge influence. The rest of the world need to chat and get it all sorted out. Okay, we're back on play here. Pablo's about to feed the ball to the rest of the world scrum. Line out at least. Sorry, the ball is tapped back. It's fed quite well. Oh, the ball is fed brilliantly out to the wing. Oh, it's carried up brilliantly. Oh, it takes it up. Oh, he's taken out. That is a great, that's the best bit of running the rest of the world have done so far. So the rest, sorry, it's an English line out now. Hopefully the rest of the world can interfere with that and secure the ball. Needs to be a good effort by them. Oh, that ball is thrown in skew, so the ref calls it fine and the ball is laid back. English feed it. Oh, he is scragged at the back and the ball is knocked forward. It seems that the, oh, no, the English have secured the ball somehow. It takes about 16 guys to bring that guy down, but he is down now and the ball is laid back. It's fed, oh, Tiff gets away quite brilliantly there. It's fed out. Oh, Skars has the ball. Oh, he's get. Oh, it's flush just miss. Oh, he gets taken out on the sideline. It's a great tackle there by English. Make their calls. About to put the ball in. Hopefully the rest of the world can spoil this. If they spoil this, they can secure a good ball. Oh, it's knocked forward by the English. The rest of the world have secured the ball. Oh, the ref calls it quickly, and it's a scrum to the rest of the world. This needs to be a great scrum. If the ball gets wide, certainly this back line can punch some holes into this English side. Let's just see what happens, folks. The ball is fit in by Larry. Oh, it's a brilliant ball. Flush takes it at the back. Oh, and he's been stopped. Tackler did not roll away. The tackler did not roll away from that tackle. Yes, the ball is definitely the rest of the world's. Hopefully they can make good use of the scrum. Get the ball out to the backs and they will punch some serious holes through their back line. You need to get the ball back quickly, though. Oh, yes, a good ball. Oh, and it's an untidy pass. Terence does quite well. He does quite brilliantly, actually. Keeps on his feet. Oh, there you go. It's a penalty to the rest of the world team. They're going to tap and go. Oh, the ref has called it off the mark. Flush is very upset about that because he was on the mark. You need to feed it to the back line. Brian knows exactly what's happening. Gets it out to Terence, takes it up a bit. Need to get that ball back. Oh, they've lost it. No, they've seemed to have reclaimed it. Unbelievably, Adam has the ball now. He lays it back, but they're going backwards, folks. And Craig has the ball now. Oh, he punches a few holes there. Lays it back quite brilliantly. But the ball is hacked on by the English. That's a great tackle by Brian. And now my phone is ringing. Where are you at the moment? Oh, Craig Kruger's punched some serious holes in this game. Oh, they just steal the ball and hack it away. Ball is punched down the middle of the field. Oh, and Terence fields it quite well. He needs to keep it in hand though. Oh, he draws his players back. Yes, oh, it's taken up by the Scottish man. Adam Crawford's in there. He's trying to drive over. But the guy's on the wrong side of the ruck, sir. They have the ball. They have the ball. Larry has the ball. Oh, and he feeds it quite brilliantly to Craig Kruger, who passes it. Oh, snappy little pass out there. On the wing. Oh, he's taken out of field. There. Craig Kruger made some big inroads there. He needed someone to offload to. Unfortunately, there was no one there. But the rest of the world are right on their line. And they are going to make some inroads. They need to win this line out, though. They need to contest and get this line out back. We'll see what happens, folks. The ball goes in now. Oh, it's a great tap back by the rest of the world. They have won the line out. Terence takes it up again. Oh, he's straight through. Oh, he's just held up, unfortunately. And the ball is laid back. Oh, it comes out. Oh, it's a knock-on. It's a knock-on. The ref hasn't seen it, unfortunately. The English are taking it up now with their bollocking prop. Well, they bring it back now. Oh, the ball just pops out from nowhere. Need to take him out. They need to take him out of the field. There, Adam makes a sterling tackle, brings him out of touch. It's a throw in to the rest of the world. The line-out is called. Pablo's going to throw the ball in. O'Brien taps it back. Oh, the ball is... Oh, he's come straight through the line-out. Oh, that's a great tackle by Craig. He has absolutely punched him. But they have kept the ball. Oh, that is almost scragged there. Ball is won back. Swung out. Forward pass there at least. Oh, but it swung out by the English. Oh, the ball goes to the back. Oh, it's run right over the top. Bounces kindly for the English. Tiff takes the ball quite well, but he gets scragged brilliantly. Adam is there again. He is holding him up. Oh, he's turned him over. He's turned him over. Adam has turned him over. The ball comes back towards... The ref has blatantly called a penalty against the rest of the world when there's a clear turnover. Adam is lying there dumbfounded as to why that happened. Okay, it's a rest of the world line-out. Pablo's going to throw the ball in. He's played quite brilliantly so far. Call is made. Feeds the ball in. Oh, it goes right over the back. It's quite skew, unfortunately. And the English will have the scrum. Ball is fed. It's a great scrum by the rest of the world. Putting a lot of pressure on there. Scrum feeds it out. Oh, it's a good pass out wide. Oh, he beats one. Beats two. Oh, he's beaten three. He's beaten three tackles. Craig Kruger's got in there and he's held the ball up. I think he's turned it over, folks. He's turned the ball over. The ref has called it the other way. English feed it wide. Oh, it's a bad knock on. It's a scrum to the rest of the world because it came off one of their players. The rest of the team need to consolidate now. They're trailing 12 points to nil. It's a timeout called by the ref. It's an injured player on the field.
I'll see you in a minute. Ball goes over the back and Tip picks it up. Brilliantly at the back. Struck back. Ball is cleared out. It's a great tackle there. Oh, a little punch kick comes in. Ball goes back. Ryan is there in defence. Oh, it's a great tackle. They have to turn this over. They must turn this ball over. They have turned it over. Ball is turned over. He's holding the ball on the ground. The ref has to give a penalty.
Oh, God.
Goes out of Craig Kruger. Punches through. Oh, he's over. No, he's just held up. Ball is laid back quite brilliantly by Craig Kruger. Ball comes wide. Terrence goes. He drives forward. The ball is laid back. That's picked up by Adam. Oh,
go well!
They needed that try quite badly. Makes the deficit 12-5 with a kick to come. It's a great try. Well worked try there by the forwards and the back line combining. It's taken by one of them under 9 it out. Oh, he lines it up. Just like Johnny. Terrence is on the ball. Yeah. He's praying that this is just He lines it up. Oh, he takes a kick. Oh, it's a great kick!
Yeah!
And Terrence, he's up and going. Ball's fed back to the forwards. Adam takes it up. They drive it. Yes, they keep driving it. They need to secure the ball though. bodies ready to the rest of your team. Because of the legal hands in there, 29 years old. Probably kicked about four balls in his life. This one goes over.
Those are full.
He's English, he'll probably kick it under the pole.
Oh,
oh, that is unfortunate. Okay, English are about to kick off after that try. The conversion wasn't made. Unfortunately hit the crossbar. Bounced straight back. Now the English are begging for the ref to make some decisions for them. It was a great little kick off. Oh, it's taken brilliantly. Need to lay it back quickly and get it out to their back line. As they do. Oh, there's a great,
nice kick.
That is a great kick.
Get on it!
That is a great kick. Yes. Yes. That is a great kick. Oh, it's a great take by Brian. Oh, unfortunately it's knocked out of his hands. Pablo picks the ball up and takes it up. Oh, he swings it off. Oh, it's a great take there by the fly half. Irish fella. He loads it back quite well. There's a player lying on the wrong side, but the ref pulls it holding in. Unbelievable call there by the ref. They're going for a tap ball. They're going for a line out. All big players have lined up. They drive it up. Oh, they're almost on a 5-yard line now, driving it up with great, great strength. They're over the try line at the moment. It can be held up. It seems to be a try in the corner. Very unfortunate mistake there.
It's a line out to the rest of the world team. They are in the English 10-yard line, just near the 22. Pablo throws the ball in. It's taken well by Brian. There's a good bit of poaching in there. He needs to drive it up and secure a good ball. Oh, the ball is taken up brilliantly. It's swung back. Craig Kruger takes the ball. Oh, it's taken up. Oh. Oh, it steps over. Ball is still secured by the rest of the world. They take it up further into the 22. The ball pops out from nowhere. Oh, Glenn is taken back quite vigorously by one of the English players. Ball is laid back. It's still rest of the world's ball. Oh, it goes blind. Oh, it's good. Oh, unfortunate pass. It's knocked back. It's a knock back. It's a knock on by the English. It'll be the rest of the world scrum on the 22. Hopefully this scrum will be better than the previous one. Oh, the ball has popped out wildly. Oh, Flex has lost the ball. Brian's picked it up, a loose ball. Oh, he's been played on the ground. The rest of the world have secured it. It's fed wide. Craig Kruger gets the ball. He takes on one tackle, two tackles. Oh, he's laid the back. Oh, he's still on his feet. He hasn't been tackled cleanly, so the ref allows it to go on. He laid the ball back now. He needs support, though. He needs support. Unfortunately, the English have stolen the ball. And the ref has called that going forward by the English. Ball's taken back to the English. It's tackled quite well. The ball is fed inside. Flush is down, lining him up. Right, he's knocked it on and it's gone out. To scrum to the rest of the world on their 10-yard line. Ball's about to be fed. There goes Tomo, the beer feeder. Oh, ref calls it. Scrum's not aligned. Come on! It's a free kick to the rest of the world. So the English players are shoving before the call. That's a great little pass. He's not 10. He's not 10. Advantage played to the rest of the world players. Adam is in there. He's driving it forward. And they have the advantage because they have the advantage. Win 10 yards. Pablo takes it up again. He lays it back quite brilliantly. Oh, it's a great little dummy there by the scrum half. He lays it back. Oh, it's a skip pass. Oh, it's unfortunate going out there. Oh, there we go. The ref has called, not advantage again. The rest of the world need to take this ball up because they'll lose advantage if they give the line out away. It's a great kick by Craig Kruger. Hopefully they can win this line out.
Matt, what do you think of this game?
Close, you know, and guys are giving 110%, and you know, and
fucking
you
just got to keep trying.
Just gets. Hang on, I'll be back.
As you see, Matt is engrossed in the game itself. Someone's lost their boot. Tiff takes it up forward. Oh, he lays it back quite brilliantly. English have one clean ball. Oh, it's well scragged there by the rest of the world player. Oh, Jamie Rockman almost nails him. Jar just misses him. The rest of the world have, no, they have lost the ball and it's uncleanly won. The first team to win the line out though. Pablo hears a call. There's a lot of interference from other players though. Oh, it's a well taken throw. It wasn't through the tended player, but it's well taken. The ball is laid back, it's there. It's there for the scrummy, but there are a lot of hands in. A lot of hands in there. The ref hasn't spotted it. The ref hasn't spotted that either. It's unfortunate. The ref is blind. Oh, it's well stolen there. Well stolen there by Flash. Flash from the rest of the world team has stolen that ball brilliantly. And now secured it, and unfortunately they have lost it again. Somehow, they keep losing the ball. Oh, it's the rest of the world scrum. The ref has called something correct. Oh, there's a free kick to the rest of the world because English guys are shoved off the mark. Oh, they take it up. Oh, take it up strongly. Oh, it's get brought down just in front of the posts. Hope they can secure a good ball here. Adam is waiting on the center position to take crash ball. They need to get good ball. Oh, the ball comes up wildly. Oh, it's taken brilliantly in there by the center. It needs to be supported though. Oh, they drive it up. They drive it up towards the try line. They need to get ball back though. They go over. They're going over. If they drop down now, they score a try. Rest of the world have a penalty now that if they use this ball correctly, they can score a try. They go wide. They need to get the ball back. The ball comes back to Pablo. Pablo takes it up. He swings it. Oh, it's offsides. Crossing. The ref calls crossing. Although the English were offsides. Accidental crossing. Where he got that from, I just don't have a clue. Maybe we'll capture it on video though. Does seem to be England's ball though. Rich. Rest of the world need to turn this ball over if they have any chance of winning. The scrum has gone well for the English. They swing it back. The ball is kicked loose. It's a great kick by Tiff, and hopefully it doesn't go in the pond. Yes, it's gonna, just catches short of the pond. So loud out to the rest of the world on the English 10-yard line. The rest of the world need a good scrum here. I do apologize. They need a good line out here to secure a good ball. Pablo needs a good throw into his jumpers. That's a great take by Flash. Hopefully his fours will get behind him and drive it up. They need to drive it up. And they've just been held. And ball has gone loose. Oh, there's a great little move there by the rest of the world team. They need to lay the ball back and secure a good ball. It's taken up by the forwards. They need to get it back though. They need to get that ball back. Oh, it's come back the way of... Oh, he's looking for someone. It's handed back by one of the English players. Knocking down by the English players. That is an illegal, it's a professional foul. Craig Kruger's taken up a few good inches. He's taken a few players in with him. They need to get the ball back quickly and get it wide. If they get it wide, they'll score. Unfortunate pass. All their players are offsides. It's another penalty to the rest of the world. Need a quick ball back to their, need a quick ball to the back line. They need with them, they need supports. The ball is laid back. Oh, it's taken in brilliantly by Adam Crawford again. If they get the ball back now. No, they've lost it, folks. The English have taken the ball again. Oh, and Tiff kicks it out on the 22. It's a big line-out for the rest of the world, guys. Come down to the dying moments. They need to win. Good ball. If they get a try here, they win the game. The ball goes, oh, it goes straight to one of the English players, unfortunately. It takes it up quite well. He lays the ball back, but it's gone out straight on the foot. It's a knock on. It's an rest of the world ball. The rest of the world team has made some bad mistakes tonight, today at least. But if they can pull it together now, they will win a unanimous victory. Yeah, that's a good tap down there by the rest of the world team. Ball is held in there. The fly-off is waiting. Oh, it's fed well. Oh, Flush takes the ball up quite brilliantly. He needs support, though. He needs support, and he lays it back. Oh, it's taken up again. They need good ball. They need good ball. If the ball comes to the back line, it can work. That's a great little stab. Hopefully someone can... Oh, it's taken... Oh, yes, he's taken out. There's a line out to the rest of the world. In there, 22. There's great pressure applied there by Craig Kruger and Cheese. And that other South African dude. The rest of the world need to win this ball back. They get it out wide. The boys can score. They can score. They can win this game. It's tapped down vigorously by Brian. Oh, it's taken in. Oh, stolen again by the English. The ball is hacked forward by Tiff, and it's a great kick because it has... Oh, no, Cheese has ridden it quite well. Oh, it's a good step there by Cheese. He swings the ball wide, and it's coming wide. But oh, yes, it's an unfortunate knock-on there by one of the Irish guys. But the ball is... Yeah, it all comes down to hands. It's a scrum to the English. We just need to have a word from Adam, though.
Give us a wave.
Ad? That's a good wave. Oh, Tiff takes it in himself. Oh, he offloads quite brilliantly. English get the ball back. Oh, it's a great pickup by Tiff. Oh, he goes straight through the gap. He needs to be tackled quite... Oh, it's a knock-on by the English. The ball is fed to the English. Get the ball back quite well. It's taken up forward. Oh, it's almost over the try line. Oh, it's just held up brilliantly. It's a dive over. No, it's held up. It's held up, the ref says. It's held up. Oh, it's a good, brilliant tackle on defense.
Oh, it's a knock-on by the English. The rest of the world have a window here. They need to keep it going, though, if the ref blows advantage, like he normally does. Oh, there's illegal offsides, but the ref just saw that. Oh, there's offsides again, but the ref's not playing advantage at all.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
Should we go through as well?
All the players are going through. All the players are going through. And the commentator is going through as well. Well played there, well played. It's good playing there. It's good playing there. It's good playing there by the English. Good playing by the English. Good playing, beautiful, beautiful by the English. Well done, well done, man. Well done, well done, well done, thanks. Well done. All right, the rest of the world, yeah! Yeah, the bad boy! The bad boy! The bad boy! Hey! The rest of the world, boys, yeah, there we go, there we go. Here come the English, the victorious English, 17-12 winners.
Well done.
Winners by scraping. Knob end. Yeah, they did play well, but they cheated and used illegal methods. They did win. Speaks for itself, guys. Mark, let's call you over here for a second.
Is this an interview?
Yes. Mark, what do you think of the game?
Well, I'm very happy with the game. Very happy with the whole day. Both teams tried really hard. Rest of the world couldn't quite do it.
Do you think the referee was good?
South African? Yes, I think he was. Yeah, I think the referee had a stress attack halfway through. But he calmed down and managed to control it in the end. But he certainly missed a few. But then what ref doesn't?
Tell us about a couple of the tries there, Mark. What do you think of them?
Mostly just sheer forward power. Just overcame the opposition defence. Just power, power, power. You know, old England style.
That's what we got from the top there. That is us. Thank you very much, Mark. See you later.
England suck!
Yeah! England take it up the pub!
That's his hair.
That's lovely. Lovely.
Fantastic.
Great, you play a great game today. Made some good hit ups. What do you think of the game?
It was good. Unfortunately, we didn't get the continuity we wanted. The boys played well. They dug deep. They had a team on the day one. So that's basically what I can say. I'm a good sportsman and they won fair and square.
There you have it. Straight from the centre's mouth.
Fuck him!
There you go. We just have to speak to the mighty Matty Shora. He played an awesome role in the game today. He was great in defence. He was great on attack. We just like to hear Matty's words.
Absolutely. We've been preparing for 12 months for this game since last year. To lose like that, it's been tough to swallow, but I'm really proud of my guys. They played so much. They did a deep ball work. Fair balls to England, they played really, really well.
There you go, fair balls to England. Unfortunately, the ref was a bit biased, but he was a few minutes. Jeez, you just played like about, 100 minutes of rugby and you guys lost, unfortunately, 17-12. It's a very unfortunate score. But I thought you guys played quite well. Where do you think you lost it?
In the forwards, really, eh? Just didn't get enough ball and lost shitloads and sucked and frustrating and get fucked. And
now for the proper in-depth nationality, let's talk to Harlan Sinclair.
And we have Toby with us.
Yes, I'd just like to say it was one of the most punctilious, plutocratic and avaricious games I've ever seen in my life.
And Nobben, speak again.
I pretty much agree with Toby. I mean, I'd have gone really for autocracy with me at the helm, but, you know, plutocracy at the end of the day is fine.
So I'm African.
And we have a South African point of view, maybe?
I can't disagree more. That's about all I have to say. I'm sorry, I'm fucking knackered.
Well, there you go. Flush, you just spoke. You flushed himself. A Scottish point of view.
Evening, dear. How are you?
Hello.
Hello. So, what are you thinking today, then? Gave her all 110%, you know, like Lon Salario and his burgers. End of the day, it was enough. Bastards.
Dirty bastards. He's crying. Oh, it's snotty all over my shoulder. Joint team manager for England. How does that feel?
Victorious again, I think. Yeah, wicked. The guys did us proud. So, it was good. Good victory, especially in the third quarter. I think that was the key with the teams like very closely matched. There was two tries each, and you know, they just our team held on. It was good work.
Yeah, it was great play by your forwards, especially in the lineouts and the scrums, and your backline was pretty good at that as well.
Yeah, I think one of our advantages with the forwards was the fact we had about five times the number they did, so they had their whole front row basically played the whole game, and we could at the end just bring on a brand new front row again and out scrummage them. Their backs played well. I mean, our backs played better, I'd say. Our defence, especially Paul Spendiff, he was just great. He just kept going. So good work with the lads. Yeah.
Good. That's excellent. Congratulations and get pissed.
Cheers.
A few words with you, young man.
What now?
Wiggy.
Was it a great game?
Yes.
Was one right in the end?
Yep.
What do you think of the game? Was it a good game? Was it tightly fought? What do you think you won the game?
I'd say more than the forwards, the backs, you know. We had to struggle. Craig Kruger came through all the time and he's a hard bloke to tackle, and every time he got through he's always mobile, so Tim Trapp played, you know, final game for Millwall and put on a sterling performance. So it was like good hard work by all round players.
There you have it. Scarce's opinion was one in the forwards.
A little less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me.
Fingers wiggle at the hoochie coochie, hoochie coochie, they come in.
Will you please specify what happened in the game today?
You are sorry, if I had a good game, if you had a good game.
No, would you please specify what happened in the game?
Oh, what happened in the game?
Yeah.
I think we showed the Colonials that we're still the best at rugby.
We kicked their ass.
That's pretty much it. We had a nice sunny day. It was a nice sunny day, but I had a good time.
Sing a song. I was going to sing a song.
A long, long time ago, I can still remember when music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had a chance, maybe they would, people would dance and maybe I would sing for a while. But February made me shiver with all the paper I deliver. Bad news on the doorstep, I couldn't take one more step.
Larry, what did you think about the outcome of today's game?
I thought the English were very lucky, but we had the biggest bollocks.
Yeah, like shit you did.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
I'm talking with the chairman of Millwall Rugby Club, Mike Costa. We've got a few questions. We want to get to know Millwall Rugby players.
Okay.
What's under your bed?
Nothing at all. It's a solid bed.
Sky Electric set.
Interesting.
What's under my bed?
Very personal.
A porn magazine.
Porn magazine. What label?
Just a regular one. Just standard Mayfair or something.
Okay.
Under my bed is currently a series of suitcases, a couple of picnic sets, and some Millwall programmes.
Excellent. What time do I go to bed?
What's under your bed?
Dust, toenails, and probably small pieces of foot that I've cut off. When my I've got one toe that sort of engrows a bit, and I scalpel it out, and that probably ends up under the bed. But there's no.
What do you use for that sort of thing?
Scalpel from work, yeah.
All right. Are you a doctor or something?
No. Advertising agency. We've got ads out.
I see.
At the moment, me, my left hand, and some nail varnish. I sometimes lean on my arm, but I've been single for a long while.
I see. What's under my bed? At the moment, tapes, books, there's like one of those kind of hanging picture frame things. There's a physiotherapy plinth. Normally my rugby kit. There's also a fluffy, spongy rugby ball. There's a camping plastic cutlery kit and a sitting bag.
So you spend a lot of time under your bed then?
And some condoms.
What, under it or on top of it?
Under it. No. I just shoved all that shit underneath.
I see. Okay.
Nothing.
Really?
On either side of it, there's some horrid items, but we won't go into that just at this particular point in time. But no, that's it.
She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L.
If you could have any superpower in the world, what would it be?
Omnipotence.
Omnipotence, why is that?
I'm already well, close. I just like to go the whole hog and absolutely to know what people were really thinking and whether I'm being bullshitted or not.
The ability to break tackles.
I didn't look that way, sorry.
That's a good question. I'd like to fly.
You'd like to fly, why is that?
Like an albatross, so I could go around the world.
Interesting.
That's a very good question, Matt. And I rejoice in your factor to give a good question. I guess it would be to fly, because to fly would be the ultimate power.
Flying, not invisibility, that shit.
Have you tried that?
Yeah, it doesn't work.
Not cut out?
No, you end up trying to rip the head off your old man in front of some bird. Next thing you know, she bumps into you because she's walking and trying to dress on in front of the mirror.
She catches on pretty quick.
Wolverine's mutant healing factor.
Interesting.
It's having an erection. That's a biology power.
Everyone else has said flying. That's the most original answer we've had all night, actually.
Well, I'm a comic book geek. What can I say?
Flight.
Boring. Let me think about it.
Okay. All right. Flight.
All right, you're going to stick with it. Wolverine's healing factor.
Be invisible. Go into ladies' changing rooms.
Actually, that's a good idea. I'd be invisible. And I'd go to the hockey roos changing room.
What? Okay.
Be invisibility, doesn't it?
Would you use that for good or evil?
Evil. Ask a silly question.
Would you run around and try and see as many people as you could naked if you were invisible?
Yes. There's no doubt about that. I would gynecologically probe them. Given any right. Opportunity.
And I think that's about all that's we need to know
that's
about Glyn Bevan.
That's
there
right.
You go.
I'm a sick old man, basically. That's what it comes down to. Yes, I am sick.
Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running.
What makes you laugh more than anything?
I don't laugh often. I smile a lot and I smile when I see other people enjoying themselves.
Most things.
Anything specific?
Not really. This interview is making me laugh. General things around the club. General things in life, really. I laugh at most things. I'm quite an amiable chap. Of comedians, Peter Kay is a very humorous bloke. He generally makes me laugh quite a lot.
Backs, generally. They make me laugh a lot. Especially when they get involved in forward play. Small penises and ugly women.
This interview right now.
Everything.
Naked. Yeah, every time I look at myself naked in the mirror, I have a good laugh. Oh. Peter Andre.
Wales, what really makes you laugh?
The plight of baby seals being clubbed by Canadians.
What really, really gets under your skin?
Two-faced people.
Having always to get naked in this club.
What upsets me? Not very much.
You strike me as a very mild-mannered sort of person.
I'm quite a mild-mannered person. However, I think waste upsets me. People wasting talent, people wasting time, people throwing litter on the street. It's all waste. So I think waste.
You strike me as a really sort of mild-mannered type of guy. What really, really gets you pissed off?
When England wins the in the England Millwall wins.
Microphone too so. Close to its face, I reckon.
Well, actually, no. And being interviewed, okay.
See, I could be really philosophical here and be a wanker, but I'd have to say that probably losing to England.
I'm right there with you on that one.
I mean, it's just one of those things.
Are you really that gutted, mate? Really, that gutted?
You know,
annoying questions.
Shall I keep going? If you must. I think we'll call that a day. This has been Carl Harris. Thank you very much.
G'day.
Who would you most like to slap?
Well, Tony Rockman's over there. But most like to slap, probably Charlotte Church.
Yeah. Peter Andre and Jordan.
I'd like to slap Peter Andre and Jordan.
No, I just like to say, I'd like to slap Charlotte Church and follow it up with a repeated slapping.
Maybe so much to do, so much to see, so what's wrong with taking the back?
What's your favourite coloured Smartie?
It's definitely the brown one.
Why?
Because I remember going to Morocco and being told that they don't have brown Smarties in Morocco because nobody eats brown. Yeah, and whereas we don't eat blue.
This has been Mike Costin.
Bearing his all.
When you make sandwiches, do you cut them diagonally into two, or do you cut them into little squares?
I don't cut them, I eat them whole.
Really? That's interesting. I see. Do you...
Sandwiches into squares, kids.
Okay. What colour is your favourite Smartie?
Orange.
Orange?
Yeah.
Does that make you laugh?
Because it tastes of oranges.
25 years of age, what have you achieved to date?
I've played on the Millwall England team who've won the rest of the world game for the past 2 years. I've never been on a losing Millwall England side.
Okay, can I rephrase that question?
If you must.
What significant thing have you done to date, unrelated to rugby?
Fuck all.
I was expecting a little bit more.
Really? Well, no, I say that. I've toured the Middle East. I've last week I fixed the hole in the ozone layer. And next week I'm trying to sort out the Israel-Palestine problem. You know, me, Yasser, and Ariel Sharon, we're going to sit down, have a couple of beers and sort it out.
What about world peace? Are you going to try for that as well?
I feel it all starts in Israel.
Who's your favourite superhero?
Who's my favourite? Well, obviously, anyone who can fly. Do you know who I really like? Do you remember back in the 80s, there was a guy called the American Hero?
Yeah.
Three steps and you took off. I really like... There you go, I like him. I thought he was brilliant. Because he was a real fuck-up. So he's my favourite.
Excellent. Okay.
He's like Wonder Woman, but just like a man.
With a bit of a curly afro.
Yeah, he was pretty shit.
How much money would they have to pay you for you to have sex with Dawn French?
How much would Dawn French want? Any idea?
She's easy, all right? So
that's right.
It's up to you.
I mean, at my age, beggars can't be choosers. So, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, I could hardly pass comment. So, in all reality, I just... It's for itself. I mean, you know, Dawn French means... Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on,
go. Kieran, we'd like to interview you in the toilets.
Taking a piss.
Yes.
Wow. Hi, Kieran. We'd like to ask you some questions. You know, how did you feel the day went?
I thought it went very well. I mean, Millwall England won. I've got stage right now. It's terrible. Yeah, so I was very pleased that Millwall England won. And I thought it was a great day. And what I like best as well, being a bit political about this now, to see when we had like the kids down was awesome. These young guys came to our club and wanted to play rugby. This club has taken such a step forward today for me. Awesome.
I wanted everyone to see the kids session.
Brilliant. I mean, just seeing those like going on, they're up for it and they like the Millwall thing. And I know Millwall and London's got a bit of like a stigma as well. So the fact we've got a name for our club means that, well, they'll come down and they'll say, yeah, I'll play for Millwall, me. And it's just, it was a good day, a great day. But look how some of my faces of one day. So typically fucking English.
Hey, this is this is Millwall reporting from the gents' toilets. Over and out.
Okay, so here we are, Millwall TV. It's good to see you all, and we've got one of the losing players today, young Matt from Australia. So Matt, how did you think the game went today, buddy? Do you enjoy it?
I did, especially when I smashed Kieran. I smashed him about 3 or 4 times. Yeah, I thought everyone in the England team played well except Kieran because he's just a joke. They would have won by 40 except he was playing. But anyway, that's just my opinion, and my opinion's usually shit. So.
Okay, I'm totally sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We didn't actually think we'd employ a retard here, but in fact, it looks like we have.
Well, I'd just like to say, was Kieran playing today? I didn't notice him out there. Did anyone notice Kieran? Was Kieran playing today? That's the main question on everyone's lips. Apparently he was there, but no one saw him. I don't know.
That's I'm such an aloof motherfucker that, you know, the likes of you in the back row.
That's a really good comment. But what I want to know is why this argument's about in the first place, because if it's about whether Kieran was there or not, whether you picked up a ball and got mullered again or not, whether Matty Shore got knocked back 6 yards, all you've got to do at the end of the day is look at the result. And now, if you can argue that result with me, what his contribution towards that result was, hey, it was a winning contribution.
I just like to say rugby was the winner today. Not the club, rugby itself.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming forth to carry me. Oh, swing low, sweet, sweet, sweet chariot, coming forth to carry me. Oh, 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 oh. Swing down chariots, won't you let me ride, oh swing.
Swing down chariots, stop and let me ride, oh rock me Lord, oh. Come and easy,
I got a home
on the other side,
oh. 6 white horses standing side by side, oh sing.
6 white horses present side by side, oh rock me Lord, come and easy,
I got a home
on the other side, hey.
Won't you let me ride, oh swing.
Swing down, Jerry, stop and let me ride, oh rock me Lord,
hey, hey, hey,
hey. I got a home on the other side,
got a home. You got a home,
we got a home,
I got a home,
I got a home,
you got a home,
we
going